Hi there, Matt Allington here. Today, just a short video, I'm going to show you how you can create a paginated report directly online at powerbi.com. First of all, let me jump over and show you a blog article I wrote back in early 2022. So back in April 2022, I wrote this article, which I called Poor Man's Paginated Reports. Now back then, approximately a year ago, it was actually much harder to write paginated reports. If you wanted to do that, you would need to use Power BI Report Builder, and that was something that was certainly within accessible reach of most people, but it's just something else that you had to learn. And so I came up with this technique where you could use Analyze in Excel to build paginated reports. But Power BI is always changing, and I just stumbled on this the other day. Maybe it was announced somewhere, maybe it wasn't, I don't know, but I'm going to show you how you can very easily create a paginated report inside Power BI. So let me jump over to powerbi.com. I'm here in my workspace. I've got a few files here, including this AdventureWorks file. Now, in order to create a paginated report, all you have to do is come to this menu here, click More Options, and you can see Create Paginated Report. Now, this option is actually available in a few different places. So if I actually click here on the data set, you get this sort of starting location. Notice that I've got Create Report, Paginated Report is here. I'm also getting a little hint up here that I can create a paginated report. So it doesn't really matter where you start from. Now, the other thing to point out is that I'm in my workspace, so you don't have to be in a group workspace, and you also don't have to have a pro account. This can work on any account, including a free account. So here I have AdventureWorks. I'm just going to create a paginated report. So let me just go ahead now and build out this paginated report. So I'm going to come over here, select calendar year. Notice a calendar year gets immediately placed on the screen and you can see a list of the years. And I can just go ahead and build out my report. Now I'm going to add a few different columns in here just to make a nice long report that goes over more than one page. That probably is enough. And I'll come down here and turn on the total sales. So now I've got this page. This is a paginated report. There's more than 500 rows. So go to reading view or export to see all the rows. So let me do that. I'll switch over to the reading view. I need to save the changes. And now that the changes have been saved, I can come up here and I can click export to PDF. And let's go and have a look at that report. And here it is. Now notice that it doesn't fit. So it fit when I was doing the web view, but when I produced the printed version, it didn't fit. So I need to come back here and make some changes. So I'll go back into Edit View. You can see there's plenty of wasted space here. So I'll just come across, resize some of these columns. Pretty easy, drag and drop. Total sales doesn't need to be that wide. And let me switch back to viewing mode again. I need to save the changes. And then we'll try and export again and take a look at the file. And there you have it, a paginated report, multiple pages. It's been sent to a PDF. Now, once you've built this paginated report, it just becomes one of the assets of your workspace. So if I come back into my workspace here, switch over to the content, notice that my paginated report now is basically one of the viewable reports which is available within my workspace. So there you have it. I don't know whether you knew that existed or not. I certainly didn't. I stumbled on it. I wanted to share it with you. So hopefully you can get some value from that.